Now we are going to start with the determiners. Now determiners are basically four types. We broadly categorize it into four kinds of determiners. The first one is the article, a and the, which you have already done in your last class. The second type is called as the demonstrative determiners. Now demonstrative basically means to point out, demonstrate or to point out at something. Now which are the words which point out? They are this and that. Where do we use this? We use this for anything which is near to us, and we use that for anything which is away from us. Both are used for singular countable nouns. Okay, so this and that is used for singular countable nouns. This is for anything which is near us. This is my pen. So this is near to me, so this is my pen. And when I want to denote anything which is away from me, so I will use that is my pen. So that means it shows it is away from me. So there I am going to use that. Okay, and the plural of this is these and that is those. So there are only four demonstrative words. They are this, that, these, those. Now just if you have earlier studied and you remember, then these demonstrative words come in demonstrative pronouns also and demonstrative adjectives also. So it is the same words, this, that, these, those. But then what is the difference between a demonstrative pronoun and a demonstrative adjective? Just find it out. We will discuss it in the next class. Okay? And because this is something which you have already done. So I want everyone to look into your grammar books and find out what is the difference between a demonstrative adjective and a demonstrative pronoun. Okay, so this is now the second type of determiners. And this, that, these, those are the demonstrative words. The third type of determiners is the possessive determiners. Now, possessive word means to show possession. Possession means showing ownership. So when you possess something, when you are the owner of something, then it is you are in possession of that object. So possessive pronoun, possessive words are my, our, your, his, her, its, and theirs. These possessive words are also present in pronouns as well as in adjectives. Again, the same thing, there is one rule which applies. What makes these words act as a possessive pronoun and what makes these words act as a possessive adjective? We will discuss it after we finish with this discussion. Now, next we have is the quantitative are determiners. Now this can be divided into number of different subcategories, but I have put all of them in one category, that is quantitative. Quantitative means which tells us the quantity. Now that quantity can be specified in numbers, so we can have the exact quantity. For example, 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg. So we can have the numbers like 1, 2, 3 or 1st, 2nd, 3rd. So it they will come under the category of numerals. Okay? And so now let's see some of the quantitative determiners. How they are used in a sentence and where they are used. Okay, now first one that I have is some and any. Students normally get confused where to use some and where to use any. So let's learn that. Some is used for a very little quantity and for an indefinite quantity. since it is quantitative, so it is indefinite quantity. Okay, and some can be used for both countable nouns as well as uncountable nouns. You will understand if you see this example. Give me some sugar. Now this is sugar is uncountable noun, and we are using it with a uncountable noun. Some is used with uncountable noun. Now I have another example. I need some volunteers. But volunteers is countable noun. So we are using it with both the uncountable noun as well as the countable noun. Okay. Now let's see, where do we use any? Any is used in an affirmative sense in questions, and it is mainly used in a negative sense. So the main function of any is when you want to say any sentence in a negative sense, then we use any. And for it is used for an indefinite quantity, and it is used with the words hardly, scarcely, barely. Just learn these words. Hardly, scarcely, barely, you use the word any with it. Okay, let's look at the example. Do you have any doubt? Here we are using it in an affirmative way in a question. And here, I don't have any money. Here I am using it in a negative way. See, I have the word don't. So I don't have any money, that is used in a negative way and in a normal sentence. The third example that I have, I hardly have any money. So I hardly have any money, and we, as I said, with the words hardly, scarcely and barely, we use the word any with it. Okay, now let's see the next one, little and much. Now little denotes a small amount and much denotes a larger amount. For example, there is little milk left in the pot. I have a little milk to my coffee. So little means very small amount. Here the now what is the difference between little and a little? The difference between little and a little is that in a little, we are not emphasizing. There is not much of emphasis put. So that means it's just a little bit, you're not putting much emphasis on the quantity. How much? It's not said exactly. So here, let's see the example for much. I have too much to count. So when we are talking about a large amount, then we are using the word much. Now let's see the next one, few, many and a few. Now few means a small amount, many means large amount. For example, few children are present in the park, many children are absent in the class today. So this specifies the quantity. Few means a smaller quantity and many means a larger quantity. Okay, and what is the difference between few and a few? Now the difference between few and a few is again the same thing. In few we are emphasizing how many number, how much number. So emphasis is on the number. There are few children, so there is emphasis on the number. Whereas when we are talking about a few, then there is no emphasis, there is very little emphasis on the number. So we say, I need a few children for the project. Now the emphasis over here is not the number of children, emphasis is on the project. So I need a few children for the project. Okay, so we see that a few is used where we are not using, a few is used where we are not using, when we are not emphasizing on a particular number. I hope this is clear with you. Here I have some more determiners. Now let's do each. Now where do we use each? When we talk about the members of a group individually, then we use each. For example, he met each guest. That means he met each of the guests, among all the guests, he met each of them individually. Okay, every Where do we use every when we make a general statement about a group? That then we use every. The minister visited every flood affected area. A general statement that he visited every flood affected area. Okay. Now, where do we use either and neither? Now, either is used when we talk about two things, and among the two things, only one thing is involved. For example, either of the two girls should come here. So, out of the two girls, there should one should come over here. So, there we are using either. Either of the two girls should come here. Okay, now the neither. Where do we use neither? Neither is basically the negative form of either. So, neither Ram nor Sunil came to the party. Now, whenever we have to say none of them, means out of two people, none of them came, nobody came. So, then we are going to say neither. Neither Ram nor Sunil came to the party. Now, the next one we have are interrogatives. Now, interrogative means questions. The words which asks questions are interrogative words. Okay. Now, which are those words? What, which, whose, etc. So, these are basically the WH words. These are basically the WH words. Now, let's look at the example. Whose house is this? Which color you like most? What subject are you studying? Okay, now what you have to keep in mind over here and be cautious is, suppose I have a question. What is your name? What is your name? Now, will you is what over here a determiner? Is what over here a determiner? Can any of them ask, just answer me? Any of you can answer me. Is what a determiner over here? What is your name? No. What is not a determiner over here? Why? Because what is used with a verb. And why what is determiner over here? Because it is used with a noun. So that's what we studied. What are determiners? Determiners are words which are used mostly before noun and noun phrases. Okay, so they precede the nouns. So see, whose house? House is the noun. Whose is the determiner? Which color? Again, color is the noun, which is the determiner. What subjects? Subject is the noun. What is the determiner? So you have to be very careful. Every sentence starting with whose, which, what, where is not a determiner. It will only be a determiner when it is followed by a noun. Okay, so this brings us to the end of determiners.